Hey guys, Mike and Benfet here from GridLife Digest, and we're going to do something a little bit different today. So I saw the movie The Commuter with my favorite actor, Liam Neeson. I thought I'd do a little video on it. Let's say maybe a review or more of a first impressions of the movie. Kind of like a half-assed review kind of thing. So I just want to show you my thoughts. And in the background, I will have some gameplay from Uncharted 2. You know, the beginning with the train where he's climbing up it. Yeah, it's because I'm talking about trains or a train movie. So have some train play in the background, if you will. Sounds like a weird foreplay, but with people dressed up as Thomas the Tank Engine. Yeah, it's a little weird. Well, anyways, enjoy. Let me know what you think. Okay. Bye. Liam Neeson has been my favorite actor since I saw the first Taken movie. All of his recent action movies in the last couple years have been canned by reviewers. They hover around okay to terrible on Rotten Tomatoes, but for some reason I have a blast with every single one of his movies. The Commuter starring this famed Irish actor is no different. Remember his 2014 movie Nonstop? Yeah, The Commuter is basically that movie, but on a train instead of a plane. What's next? Stick Liam on a bus, in a boat, maybe even in a Geo Metro? The possibilities are endless. Anyways, we're getting a little bit off topic, so let's get back to the review. I didn't read anything about The Commuter going into it, and that was my first instinct that it'd be similar to Nonstop. All I had seen was the name of the movie, and I knew for sure it was going to be on a train. The Commuter starts out with the main character named Michael, played by yours truly, Liam Neeson, being fired from his supposedly stable job. On his daily commute back home, a random lady sits next to Michael and tells him he will receive $100,000 if he can find one particular person on the train ride home. At first, it seems like a fun scavenger hunt, but of course, it turns deadly. In this Liam Neeson movie, his character's relationship with his family isn't as fleshed out as his past movies. Neeson's wife and son are just kind of thrown in there showing, oh yeah, he has a family. Most of his previous films are centered around Liam's characters having some sort of problem with his family member. In Taken 1 and 2, his daughter and wife are both taken from him. In The Gray, Neeson had several flashbacks from saddening moments with his wife. In 2015's Run All Night, the old badass actor has to protect his son from a gang. In The Commuter, they are only used as leverage by the main antagonist, but only in mentioning. There are two full scenes of his son and wife, and they are at the beginning and end of the movie. I was at the edge of my seat the whole second act. Neeson is pretty much forced to find a mysterious character I talked about earlier. He has to use his wits to find the sought-after character, and how he does it is very entertaining. The ultimate bad guy in this new action flick is, of course, the character they hardly talk about throughout the movie, and it's a big plot twist at the end. Let me talk about the third act here for a second, though. It felt long and dragged out, mostly because I thought the movie was going to end shortly. Even though it was long, it ended up closing some plot holes, which was great. Overall, The Commuter is a great Liam Neeson film and an okay action movie, but I highly recommend it anyways. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to follow us on @GridLifeDigest on Twitter and all of our social media and whatnot. Most importantly, subscribe to this YouTube channel because we are so close to 69 subscribers. Only like 9 more, so please, do it. Stay tuned for more videos being released every Monday and Friday. It's like a big old sandwich of GridLife Digest. The video on Monday is like a piece of bread. The newest episode of GridLife Digest is like a big old fucking piece of turkey. And the video going out on Friday is like the other piece of bread. Stay tuned to get the whole delicious turkey sandwich of GridLife Digest. Until then, this is Micah Benfet signing out. See you guys later. Don't be riding any trains with suspicious characters.